So what we have been focusing on is a tool for volunteers to be matched up with charities. So if you do some research online, you can find that there are already loads of websites which list out charities looking for volunteers, so they will have very specific needs. But there's nowhere for volunteers to really kind of register an interest in volunteering within a certain area. And we also identified from one of the focus groups yesterday that charities kind of have this mismatch between what charities want and what volunteers want. So volunteers want to give away a certain amount of time because they've got a full-time job. They want to give away like 2 hours on a Thursday, but charities kind of want people for events or want people kind of almost full-time. They're not really aware of the constraints that are placed on a potential volunteer. So we wanted to create a system where it sort of matched those needs together. So it works for both charities and for volunteers. Let's have a look at what it looks like for a charity first. So you enter in the charity name and where you're located. We didn't get a chance to build the geolocation stuff, but that feels like something that is valuable.
Oh yeah. So all charities need to get approved first to make sure that like it's not just someone signing up and becoming offensive.
So Ryan's just approving this charity that we just heard.
Totally legit.
Not do it.
That's charging the name.
Yeah.
Cool.
Turns out not to be the concept, but there is a good name.
So a charity can update their details, obviously. See volunteers near. So there's Ryan. He's willing to give away 9 hours per week on these days. He's got skills in accounting. He's near SE1, and he's willing to go within 1 mile. If you go back, have a look at what else the charity can do. So add some charity needs. So at the moment, this charity hasn't registered that they need any particular skills, but we can register some skills, so kitchen work, for example. Maybe they need 4 hours of kitchen work on a Saturday or a Sunday.
How does that work?
It's like controlled or something.
Yeah, that's all.
And that will add it to the list. Are we ready to look at volunteers?
All fine.
There was some last minute fixes.
No.
You're going to tell us you did this in 45 minutes now,
aren't you? Mr. Robert is volunteer.
One set up. That's not really what that is.
Max.
Charity again,
apparently. What?
sorry, I haven't missed it.
Can you not just sign up for a new...
Yeah, no, yeah, sign up. No, sign up.
Sign up?
Yeah,
for anyone?
Yeah, for a chat. We're all here. Probably faster.
Cool. I want to volunteer. Name is... number of hours per week. You can choose the days that you are willing to volunteer. You can choose your skills. We've got a very small list at the moment. Can volunteer around a particular postcode and where you're willing to travel. And this came up about DBS checking.
Yeah, so one of the things we'd like to do taking it forward is to allow people to upload their DBS check photos and then you volunteer to go into an approved state as well. But we then went and checked that they actually had submitted a DBS check and that it was valid and everything.
Mm-hmm. And the other thing is to kind of give volunteers a sense of that there's charities actually in the system, actually show some charities near them. Even if the charity doesn't contact them, they can be proactive, just like the other websites. And one thing that we thought we could do is scrape from all the 15 sources all of that data and put it into one place to create like a go compare of charities that are looking for volunteers. Yeah, that's pretty much it.